Hello there, everyone. Welcome to Blue Point News live on Channel App.
I'm Sunani Salanai.
And I'm Tishan Bas. President Mahinda Rajapaksa revealed that the dream of Elam has re-emerged as a political agenda at present. The demand of the Taika leader Prabhakaran made in 4 years ago has been released as the election manifesto of certain leaders. Addressing a mass rally in Vavuniya today, the president pointed out that no one will be allowed to divide and separate the motherland. The mass rally organized to ensure the victory of Vavuniya District UPFA candidates contesting at the Northern Provincial Council election was held in Vavuniya town under the patronage of President Mahinda Rajapaksa. He pointed out that no one in the South and North likes to lose the freedom gained by them. The president reiterated that no one can live in the country inciting racism, heeding the Elam dream. He added that children in the South are making a request to learn Tamil. He said that when he visited Kirinochil recently, parents have requested from him to send Sinhala teachers to teach them Sinhala. This was embedded in the hearts of these people. He disclosed that rights given to other provinces had been given to the northern province as well. The election manifesto of some political parties was highlighting the same demand made 4 years ago. He categorically stated that he will never allow anyone to divide the country into pieces, as he has not allowed even Prabhakaran to do so.
මම විශේෂයෙන්ම කියන්න ඕන මේ රට නැවත කෑලිවලට බෙදන්න ප්‍රභාකරන්ට ඉඩ දුන්නා නැතුව වගේම අනිත් අයටත් ඉඩ දෙන්නේ නැහැ කියලා.
Speaking in Tamil, the president told the gathering that everyone should be united to develop the country, shedding caste, creed, racial or religious differences. He pointed out that separatism, racism and terrorism are not needed hereafter. He said that we all are children of one mother.
Nam Lorum Brutai Makali. Within Sinnam, Vetile Sinnam, Within Sinnam, Vetile Sinnam, Nandri Wanakam.
Muslim Congress candidate M.M. Uwais, contesting the Northern Provincial Council election, has joined the United People's Freedom Alliance at the meeting. Minister Susipem Jayant Tissakaraliad, Rishad Badiuddin, Deputy Minister A.L. Hizbullah, Parliamentarians Prabhaganeshan, Unais Farooq, S.C. Muthukumaran, and HPPSN and Vavuniya SLFP organizer Prem Ratna Sumithipala were among the large gathering attended the mass rally.
Meanwhile, election campaign of the United People's Alliance in the North has been intensified, with several people representatives expressing their views at the Alliance rally in Vavuniya chaired by the President. Vavuniya SLFP organizer Prem Ratna Sumathipala said that the Alliance will be able to fulfill their balanced work if the party wins in the upcoming provincial council election in the North for the first time after 30 years. There was no need to vote for UMP or JVP, he said. Minister Rishad Badiuddin noted that the president was responsible in restoring peace in the country. It has helped us to live without fear or suspicion in the district. There was a program being implemented to disrupt the peace and to divide Sinhala, Tamil and Muslim communities. Such attempts should be defeated, he said.
ඒවා අපි නැති කරන්න ඕන
UPFA MP S.C. Muthukumaran noted that the aim of the leader is to transform this country to prosperous nation in the future. Therefore, people should cast their votes for a group headed by such leaders in the upcoming Northern Provincial Council election. Minister Susil Premajanta noted that the Northern Provincial Council election is not an opportunity given to the people on demand or request made by anyone. The President has given opportunity to select people's representatives to the Northern Provincial Council on the 21st of this month, he said.
Our religious dignitaries pointed out that the manifesto released by the Tamil National Alliance for the upcoming Northern Provincial election is a detrimental document against the country, which will break the communal harmony. They strongly protested against this policy statement of the TNA. Several religious leaders expressed their views on this issue at a media conference in Colombo today. The president of the Dhamma Rashmi Foundation, the Venerable Galagama Dhamma Rasmi Thero, pointed out that they have released a policy statement suitable for their agenda and their ideology, which was the inspiration of the LTTE terrorism. The president of the Foundation for National and Religious Amity, Reverend Father Sarath Thiyarachi, said that this party was trying to bring Prabhakaran again to the stage as a hero. The people who are contesting the election were trying to make Prabhakaran as a hero, and this tiger leader was responsible for the acts of violence, including killings of people, slitting throats of Buddhist priests, exploding bombs and setting fire to buses. The head of the Sri Lanka Mohammadiya organization, Reverend Dr. Hazarna Maulana, pointed out that the Tamil National Alliance was making an attempt to infuse life blood into the brutal war again. This was clear to the whole world.
LTD Prabhakaran Varge, Mema Tastavadinge, Aramuna, Ista Karana Vidyatama, Egolange, Sielama, Metivarna Prakashan Valdiani.
The Secretary of the International Hindu Religious Federation, the Reverend Ramachandran Gurukul Babu Sharma, said the Tamils will not accept such manifestos. Sometimes TNA was demanding a Tamil Elam, but they are also asking the vote of the people. The aim was to get the votes of the Tamils, misleading them, he further said.
The new Prime Minister of Australia, Tony Abbott, says that he will definitely attend the upcoming Commonwealth Heads of States meeting in Sri Lanka. He was elected as a new Australian Prime Minister in the general election concluded last Saturday. The Australian government has confirmed the Prime Minister's participation in the Commonwealth Summit today. The Sydney Morning Herald newspaper quoted government sources as stating that this was officially informed to the Sri Lankan President. Not a single member country of the Commonwealth has so far announced that it will not participate in the upcoming summit. The British government last week has officially announced that Prime Minister of Britain David Cameron and Foreign Minister William Hague will attend the Commonwealth Summit in Colombo. Tiger sympathisers had made a great attempt to prevent the participation of British Prime Minister in the Commonwealth Heads of State meeting. This attempt was completely unsuccessful, sources said.
An unscrupulous racket-related drinking water bottle production business has been revealed. It was detected in a surprise search operation conducted in Petah today on the directions of the Minister of Health. Several details on this racket were received by the Health Ministry. It has been revealed that certain wholesale and retail traders in Petah were in the practice of selling bottled water unhygienic for drinking. A large stock of such bottles with forged brand names has been seized during the surprise raid. The SLS certification had been fraudulently inserted in the label of these water bottles. According to the regulations, the date of the production and the date of expiry, as well as the number of registration, should be clearly printed in the label. The registration number should begin with the English letters CFA, but in certain water bottles, it was fraudulently indicated as CSA. The health minister informed the public that they should not purchase such drinking water bottles. A large stock of food items and fruits unsuitable for human consumption has also been seized during today's raid. A search operation was conducted by a group of officials including the Director General of Health Services, Dr. Palitha Mahipala, and the Chief Medical Health Officer of the Colombo Municipal Council, Pradeep Karyavasam. President Mahinda Rajapaksa said that parents in the north are not prepared to allow terrorists to proscribe their children again. The aim of the government is to provide everything to the people in the north except the lives lost in attack terrorism. The president reiterated that no one will be allowed to gain petty political objectives spreading racism and religiousism. The president was speaking at the Manna District Alliance mass rally held at the Manna Urban Council Stadium this evening. Former LTT Manna District political leader E. Sivanaduraja and several former LTT members have joined the UPFA, extending their fullest support to the president's development process. President Mahinda Rajapaksa pointed out that the present government has built temples, churches and kovils, and it will build places of religious worship, but it will never damage such places. The responsibility of the people is not to fall prey for false propaganda. He called upon the people in the north to join hands with the government with his committed for the development of the country.
Addressing
the gathering, the president pointed out that everyone knows the policy of the LTTE. He said that he believes that the TNA was not in favor of the LTTE policy. They appeared as councils of the LTTE in the parliament during the war due to fear. Tamil youths have sacrificed their lives in the past, but where were the TNA leaders at that time, the president asked. They have sent their children to countries like UK, Canada and USA for further studies. Not a single child of TNA leader is studying here in Sri Lanka. The president asked the people in the area to inquire about it. Their main aim and their action was on behalf of people in another country. Sometimes they were attempting to bring back separatism in the country. He said that people cannot go back to such an era. Not a single mother wants to allow their children to become disabled. He called upon the people not to risk the youth in the country to implement petty ideas of these politicians.
මුලේ තියෙන පාවිච්චි කළ පොඩි කාලේ කුඩා කාලේ ඉඳලා කිරි දීලා හදාගත්ත දරුවව නැවත තරුණ වයසට ඇවිල්ලා අපඝාතේ කරන්නට කිසි අම්ම කෙනෙකුට ඕන නැහැ කිසි තාත්තා කෙනෙකුට ඕන නැහැ එයාලගේ පටු අදහස් ක්‍රියාත්මක කරන්න මේ රටේ තරුණයෝව බිලි දෙන්න එපයි කියලා මම TNA එකට කියනවා मेरा मिनी पहुस
Mante, Pradhi Sabha member of the Muslim Congress, Ralph Master, and Mana Pradhi Sabha member Arafat have got onto the stage extending their support to the All Island Muslim Congress of Minister Rishad Badruddin, Minister Sisi Prem Jayanth Rajit Senaratna, Deputy Ministers Sarath Kumar Gunaratna, A.L.A. Hizbullah, and parliamentarians Prabhak Ganesan and Unais Farooq attended the mass rally.
Former LTT provincial leader Prabhanandan says that the Tamil National Alliance is engaged in politics for their own benefits. He was speaking at a UPFA mass rally in Manna today. Former LTT provincial leader in Manna, Prabhanandan, said that our political leaders had taken us for a ride in the recent past. They have taken political advantage from us. After understanding their hidden agenda, we have joined the government. He added that he is committed for the victory of betel leaf symbol and the development of the country.
Professor Mayurva Samarakund accused certain non-governmental organizations for submitting non-scientific reports on Sri Lanka after the defeating of terrorism. He made this accusation quoting a UN research report. The UN research report was devised by taking a sample of 10,000 persons in 6 selected countries. According to the report, 14.5% of Sri Lankan men was accused of raping women. It also contains details of countries like Papua New Guinea, Indonesia, China, Cambodia and Bangladesh. Professor Mayurva Samarakund, Social Science Faculty of Sri Jayawardenepura University, said that at present there was an attempt to block the opportunity of the country to move forward by highlighting small issues without highlighting the progress of the nation. According to the UN report, Sri Lanka is not facing a serious rape crisis in relation to other countries. However, Professor Mayurva Samarakund pointed out that such international organizations were issuing these reports with anti-Sri Lankan objective. Professor Mayurva Samarakund, Social Science Faculty of Sri Jayawardenepura University, said that the need of the Western countries was to establish that Sri Lanka is a country which is not developing at present. This was a serious situation, he further said. Meanwhile, the U.S. Attorney General's Department has also presented a report on raping this year. It indicated that around 89,000 U.S. women had been raped this year. 23.2% of women in the UK has been sexually abused in Belgium. This was a number 26.2% and 30.2% women in New Zealand have come under the threat of raping. But these countries were not included in the UN report. Accordingly, the aim of the pressure revealed by certain NGOs against the country like Sri Lanka was to create a false picture on the island nation globally. This was stated by Professor Mayurva Samarakund of Sri Jayawardenepura. Meanwhile, Sri Lanka France cooperation in public-private partnerships for infrastructure development was highlighted at a seminar held in Colombo today. The seminar was jointly organized by the French Embassy in Colombo and Sri Lanka Board of Investments. Deputy Secretary to the Treasury, Dr. B.M.S. Batagoda, delivered the keynote address. The seminar revealed details on how public-private partnerships can contribute to reinforce the efficiency of public service delivery. It has been disclosed that this partnership was not merely a financial model, but offers an innovative mode of public procurement and public service management for those who seek technical economic optimization in line with the government objectives. Economic Councillor of French Embassy Jean-Louis Pauli and the Director General of Board of Investments, Dr. Lakshman Jayavira, delivered the opening and the welcome addresses respectively. The director of the French PPP task force, François Bergier, made a presentation on the French experience.
The construction work of the largest tunnelway in the Umaoya multipurpose irrigation scheme has been launched. The excavation of the tunnel is being carried out using machinery through Valle Wire, Karandagola rocks. Speaker Chama Rajapaksa was the chief guest. A 15.5-kilometer tunnel is running up to Dairab area in Valimada. The main reservoir is to be built in Puhulpula, Valimada. $529 million will be spent for the project under the Iranian line of credit. The Sri Lankan government will also spend 7.5 billion rupees for the Umaoya project. 100 German technicians and 700 Sri Lankan technical officers are engaged in the excavation work of the tunnel. The project director, Dr. Sunil Silva, says that the number of workers will be increased up to 3,000 in the future. The 28% of the construction has been completed. The excess water of Umaoya will be used to meet the water requirement of the people in the Monragala district. 300 megawatts of hydropower will also be generated by the Umaoya plant.
The country's ace leg spinner Rangana Herath has been adjudged as the Cricketer of the Year at the Sri Lanka Cricket Awards 2013 ceremony held in Colombo yesterday. The colourful awards night was organised by Sri Lanka Cricket. Kumar Sangakkara received the award for the most popular cricketer of the year. Angelo Matthews was adjudged the best all-rounder. Rangan Aheras received the award for the best test bowler.
And that's all stories for the moment. Do join us once again tomorrow at the same time to take a look at the video from the world of news. Good night.